entirely by inhibiting complex 3 through Annamycin A. So it allows you to measure the baseline oxygen consumption. And then by adding oligomycin, you can see the amount that is linked to ATP production and the amount of oxygen consumption that is not linked to ATP production. You can see the maximal. And what's left after inhibiting electron transport is referred to non-mitochondrial or sometimes proton leak. This is basically the background, among other things. And an interesting parameter, too, is reserve capacity. Reserve capacity is it's something to think about. It's the difference between the maximum and the baseline. Because this is when the cells are just in culture, this is what they're doing. This is what they're capable of doing. So the reserve capacity is a parameter that's been proposed to be a measure of a cellular ability to call upon sort of a metabolic reserve in response to stress. So an ability to persist when there are obstacles in the way of the cell metabolizing. So here is an actual experimental trace now of three individual wells from our mice. So you know what you're looking at now with the oligomycin injection, the FCCP, and the Annamycin A while we're consuming oxygen over time. Our FEV baseline are the blue line. The C57 minks are in red, and the VALP-C minks are in green. And the first thing that we can appreciate is that our FEV C57 minks animals have a significantly elevated baseline oxygen consumption rate. And I'll talk about what that may mean in a second. Also interesting is that their background is all roughly similar, so it's good as a sort of inter-experimental control to see if they're not different. And then finally, we're going to talk about the reserve capacity, and you can appreciate, perhaps initially, how the difference between the maximum and the baseline in our C57 mixed animals is almost zero, whereas there is sort of an intermediate reserve capacity in our FEV and a higher reserve capacity and our BALP-C minx animals. So this is just one trace from basically representative traces of three different experimental groups. But here's a summary report of all the pooled animals from each of the different backgrounds, and it just drives those points home. Again, the baseline oxygen consumption levels and our FEV C57 minx mice are significantly higher than either of the other two, which are very similar pretty much across the board. So what that could mean, especially given that these are the group that had the delayed primary tumor onset, the diminished metastasis capabilities. So it appears as though potential explanation could be that the oxygen consumption, they have to just consume more oxygen to meet the same metabolic needs. Basically, you've got one of two options in a theoretical sense. Because these are, what are these cells trying to do? They're tumor cells that are trying to proliferate quickly and then disseminate and metastasize. And given that these guys can do it and these guys do it slightly less well, we've got a group that are consuming a lot more oxygen and aren't quite doing that nearly as well. So perhaps it could be indicative of a metabolic inefficiency. But secondarily, and I think more importantly, kind of the take-home message from a lot of this that I'd like to talk about is the reserve capacity measure. As I mentioned quickly previously, significantly different between groups, and you see a heightened reserve capacity in our BALP-C animals, the difference between the maximal and the baseline as compared to the BALP-C, the BLAC6 rather, and the FEV. And here it is in an easy to digest form. The full pie chart, the full 100%, refers to the total potential oxygen consumed during that assay. And we see that the reserve capacity in the FEV, the baseline, the FEV wild type,